As the games near a close, there are still some big events to take place here at the 27th Winter Universiade. We'll go to the Igloo for curling bronze medal games. On the men's side, Great Britain opposes Sweden, while for the women, defending bronze medalist Switzerland face Sweden. Then it's gold medal women's hockey in a rematch of the 2013 gold medal game between Canada and Russia. And finally, we hit the slopes for the women's slalom. Pavilion in Granada. It is men's curling action bronze medal game. This will feature Great Britain and Sweden. There you see the Great Britain rink skipped by Kyle Smith, and then the Swedish rink skipped by Gustav Eskilsson. Fourth stones thrown though by Patrick Maybert. Move now here into the second end. No score, so the first end was blanked. And UK skip Kyle Smith with an open draw for two. And you'll see here he makes no mistake, and Britain takes a 2-0 lead. Now to the fifth end, 2-1 now the UK up on Sweden. Here is Kyle Smith looking to freeze to the Swedish rock in the rings. You'll see the three there. A UK rock sandwiched between the two Swedish yellows. And Smith executes the freeze quite well. A little bit of a nudge. And now Maybergs analyzes his situation. His final stone of the end. Maybergs is a three-time World Junior Curling Championship participant, winning one silver. And his shot here will curl just a little bit much and actually nudges the UK stone into shot position. So now Smith with hammer for the open draw here for two. Super's just clearing any debris out of the way, and that's an easy draw. UK scores two, and they move in front 4-1. Now to the sixth. Here is Smith again. The take out of the Swedish rock, and the shooter will roll just outside the 12-foot. And now Maybergs with an opportunity for a takeout for two to get back into this one. Super's working this one pretty hard, but no problem, easy takeout. Sweden now down 4-3. Now Kyle Smith here in the seventh. He has won a bronze in 2012, a gold in 2013, and a silver in 2014 at the World Junior Curling Championships. Here you see he's gonna really spread the rings and force Sweden into a tough decision here. Now Maybergs, he's going to attempt a really difficult double takeout. Gets the one there, but just doesn't quite have the angle on the second. And so now Smith with a draw here. It appears like it's a draw for two, but that third rock at the back of the 12-foot may count as well. So there is the draw. So it's two for sure. And you see they'll now get a measurement on that third one. You see right there at the back of the 12-foot, just right on the edge. And there is the measurement, but it is just outside the rings. So Great Britain now up 6-3. Here's Maybergs first of the eighth end. And it's going to be a miss as it sails right past that UK rock. And they're able to sweep it right out of the rings. And now Mayberg's final stone here in the eighth end. Another double takeout attempt. He'll get the one, but not the second, and the UK steals one. Now to the ninth. Mayberg's first stone. The rings are empty. They're going to let this one go in. And then they're going to shake hands. That's going to be it. And Great Britain, skipped by Kyle Smith, will win the bronze medal in men's curling action here at the Granada Universiade. 7-4 the final in this one. We'll now move over to the women's bronze medal game between Switzerland and Sweden. They met earlier in the round robin with Sweden beating Switzerland 8-3. Switzerland skipped by Michelle Yeagy. She won the bronze medal in Trentino at Universiade. Sweden skipped by Sarah McManus, who was a skip at the 2012 and 2013 World Junior Curling Championships. 6-5, Switzerland leading. Sweden with three in the rings, looking to draw to the button here right now. Supers worked that one really hard, and they'll get it right to the button. Sweden now lying four. Now Yeagy with the draw to try to avoid a big Swedish end. Can they pop it in and get rid of that one Swedish stone? It'll actually sail a little bit wide, and it's going to be a steal of two for Sweden, so they move in front 7-6. In the 10th end, here's McManus' final stone. Lots of weight on this one. Supers letting it go. She'll remove the one Swiss rock and nudge the other one. And now here is Yeagy with the takeout for two and the win. Supers just keeping the ice clean. It's going to be a perfect shot. There's the takeout. Switzerland scores two, and Michelle Yeagy and her rink from Switzerland will win their second straight bronze medal at the World University Games, 8-7 in this one over Sweden, to avenge their loss earlier in the round robin. There you see hugs all around for the Swiss rink. And the final score. Gold medal game still to come in both men's and women's curling. Women's ice hockey gold medal game here from the Granada Sports Palace in Spain. Russia taking on Canada. They met earlier in the tournament with Russia defeating Canada 3-1. Canada has won all three previous gold medals at the World University Games. Russia won a silver back in 2013. Russia is undefeated to this point in the tournament, 3-0. They won 12-1 over Kazakhstan and 3-1 over Canada during the round robin portion, and then won their semifinal 10-0 over China. Canada went 1-1 in the round robin portion, winning 7-1 over Kazakhstan and then losing that game 3-1 to Russia, their first ever loss at Universiade competition. They then beat Japan 5-2 in their semifinal. These two teams met in the 2013 gold medal game, with Canada winning 5-0. Starting goaltender for Russia, Yulia Leskina. She has a .956 save percentage and a .92 goals against average. For Canada, it'll be Elodie Rousseau-Sirois, who has a .903 save percentage and a .203 goals against average. Brianna Lancel there with the first chance for the Canadians. Then they win the draw back to Ariane Barker, but that one stopped and then batted away by Leskina. Now Shoshina with a nice toe drag there around Gosling, but she fires that puck high and over the net. Russia now on the power play, gets centered in front, but the rebound comes out and is knocked down the ice by the Canadians. Here a nice deflection for Canada, the beneficiaries. Daly Audie with the chance, but stopped by Leskina a couple times. Then it is Belyakova who gets run over as she tries to backhand it towards the goal. All that results in no scoring after the first period. Now to the second. Anna Shokina, one of the leading goal scorers in the tournament, gets her sixth of the games on the wraparound. She comes around and gets it right under that right pad of Rousseau-Sirois and off the other post and in. 1-0 in favor of Russia. Now Tess Houston for Canada back the other way. A little soft wrister, easily stopped by Laskina. And then Houston's University of Alberta teammate Jessica Campos with a shot. That one's blockered away by the Russian keeper. Now it's Mantha for Canada. She'll wrist one through. That's also stopped. Daly Audie with a little shot there late that Laskina doesn't appreciate. And now Litchfield Med for Canada out of the corner. She centers it. A bit of a scramble in front, but as they did throughout most of the game, Russia able to clear it away. Now here's leading scorer in the tournament, Olga Shoshina. She backhands that one just wide. And then that slap shot gets through from Shukina, but stopped by Canada. Canadian fans looking on. Now with Russia on the power play, here's Olga Shoshina, and she'll rifle one. It beats Rousseau-Sirois, but not the goalpost, and comes straight out. Just a rocket there from the Russian number 18. Now Shokina with one there that is stopped fairly easily by the Canadian goaltender. Now move into the third period. Russia again on the power play and a nice little pass there from Gavrilova. She sets up Shokina for her second of the night, tournament leading 7th. And Russia now with a 2-0 lead as Rousseau-Sirois got sliding one way in the nice backhand goal there by Russia's number 19. Now Rousseau-Sirois decides not to play this one, and Shoshina with the chance. She'll circle around, set up Belyakova. Nice save there by Rousseau-Sirois. Now just over 8 minutes to go. Here's Sarah Casorso. She'll turn it over, and Pavlova comes in and fires one upstairs. Top shelf, 3-0, Russia leading, and their fans ecstatic as they are now that much closer to a gold medal win. And that is what will happen. Russia wins their first ever Women's Universiade Hockey gold medal, knocking off defending champions Canada 3-0. Absolutely full measure for the win. They were the best team throughout this whole tournament. They only gave up 2 goals in the 4 games that they played. Yulia Laskina in goal was outstanding again tonight, really not giving Canada anything. Canada did outshoot Russia 40-34. Olga Shoshina finishes as the tournament leading scorer with 3 goals and 10 assists in 4 games. Anna Shokina was second in tournament scoring with 12 points and led it in goals with 7. It is Russia's second straight medal. They got silver, as mentioned, in 2013. Canada's 4th straight medal, their first ever silver to go along with the 3 previous gold medals they've won. Japan claims the bronze medal. From the Sierra Nevada mountains just outside of Granada, Spain, is the women's slalom race here at the 27th Winter Universiade. Temperature today minus 10 degrees. We've had some up and down temperatures throughout the week here in the mountains. A couple days just a little bit above 0 Celsius, but a lot of days right in around where we are today, about minus 10, minus 12. First up, it is Thea Grosvold of Norway. This is her first run of 2. The combined time will be used to rank the skiers. She finished 36th in the Super G back on February 6th here at Universiade, but then did not finish the Giant Slalom. There you see the time to beat, Pekinikar of Canada, and Grosvold will do it quite easily, over 7 seconds ahead to move into first place. Now it is Eve Routier of Canada. She was 5th after her first run in the Giant Slalom, but then did not finish her second run. You get a good wide-angle view there of her working her way down the course. And at the interval, just a little bit ahead of Grosvold. There's the time to beat through the final gates, and 4/100ths back. So she'll move into second spot, a good run for the Canadian. Now back up top, this is Monica Huebner of Germany. She skis for the University of Denver in the United States. You can see that on her helmet. A coming up to the interval. She'll be 15 one-hundredths of a second behind the leader, Grossvold. Carving well through these gates. And as she makes her way to the finish line, time to beat, still not beaten. 35 one-hundredths back of Grossvold. Now it is Catherine Auer, Austrian skier. Earlier in the week, she did not finish in the Giant Slalom. So trying to have a better result here today. A little bit behind at the interval. Of course, the slalom, the most technical of the races. You can see her now just at the line, and she will move into first place. 27 one-hundredths ahead of Grossvold. And there you have the leaders after the first run. It is Auer in first, followed by Grossvold and Routier. Now to Huebner. She was fourth after the opening run. She's from Garmisch-Partenkirchen, which of course was the site of the 1936 Winter Olympic Games. She did not finish in the Giant Slalom here earlier in the week at Universiade. So trying to improve on her time of 49.12 in the opening run. Working her way down here to the finish line. And she will move into first place, at least temporarily, 46 one-hundredths ahead of Kachenko of Russia. Now it's Routier of Canada. Third after the first run. Just a little bit back there at the interval. She's from Université Laval in Canada and was fourth at last year's Canadian National Championships in the slalom. Carving well, keeping good speed down the hill. Comes over that final crest and towards the finish line. Will she have enough to beat Huebner? No, just in behind, 14 one-hundredths back of the German. Now it's Grossvold, second after the opening run. Time of 48.77 seconds. She too skis in the United States for the University of Colorado and was 19th in the slalom back at Universiade in Trentino in 2013. Good speed here through the gates. And over that final crest to the final few gates. Makes those turns. And she will move into first place just ahead of Monica Huebner. And she likes that run a lot. And now Catherine Auer, our leader after the first run. With a time of 48.50. Behind, though, of Grossvold here right now. A little bit out of control through that gate, and can she control it? No, she'll get past the gate, but basically came to a dead stop. So Auer, our leader after the first run, gonna make her way down the course, but she's going to finish well back. You see it there, almost 4 seconds back. And there's the celebration. Thea Grossvold of Norway, the gold medalist in women's slalom, followed by Monica Huebner of Germany with silver, and Eve Routier of Canada takes the bronze medal.